But yeah, so yes, I think some things are very, very interesting, and other things I'm like, yeah, I don't buy this. Hello, my lovely nestlings, and welcome to today's video, which is makeup commentary. It's the new makeup releases that is on my series, really, on my channel every single Friday, and I have a lot of fun things to talk about. I am pre-filming this one day though. Instead of Thursday, I'm filming it on Wednesday because it needs to be done on Thursday. I don't have time on Friday because I'm getting a new tattoo. Yes, I'm very excited about it. I will try to vlog it, but I will probably fail, as I usually do. Yes, I failed to film this. I was planning on filming it for Instagram this morning, but I forgot. It's done with this one from BH Cosmetics, the Optimistic AF palette. This is what she looks like. If you want to see her in action, I do have a video with this one on my channel. But I just played with the yellow, the orange, deepened it up with this one. Then this one is on the lower lash line, this is on the lid, and this is just, oh, so stunning. And then that is in the inner corner. And that is it. Lippy is from Kiko Milano, a smart fusion lipstick in the shade 456, which was a gift. I got it in yesterday, I believe. But I think it complements everything very, very well. Yes. Falsies are from AOA Studio in the style Jean, in case you are wondering. Okay, let's open up my Instagram. I'm going to go to the side here and hope I don't fall off the screen like I usually do. I have some very sparkly things and also some questionable things. And this is a brand that I don't talk about ever. But the channels that I watch that do these types of videos never mention Niamh Cosmetics. However, one of you, my lovely subscribers, it's one of your favorite brands. You sent me a picture or a moving image of all sparkly goodness, and I thought, let me kind of see if I can find a better picture for in the video, and I have, and that's this. So this is the new collection from Niamh Cosmetics. It is called Metal Amnesia. They are foiled eyeshadows with a new finish. They can be applied both dry and wet, and they are mineral based, if I am not mistaken. So I actually just received some mineral things from Niamh Cosmetics. Among them, a mineral loose peach corrector, but I don't really know how to use that. Do I just, is that like a, do I set my face with that? Do I buff it in? I don't know. I have questions. Very intrigued though. But this looks very, very pretty. Oh, there are stunning shades here. Oh, that Shakudo, I think it's called, which is a, looks like a black. They look very, very pretty and sparkly. Yeah. I have some things from Niamh Cosmetics here. Not a lot, but some. So I kind of wanted to let you guys know about this brand. They are based in Italy. Have you tried them? Do you know this brand? Let me know down below. I will leave their site down below. Honestly, I think they sell internationally, but I'm actually not sure. You learn something new. Yeah, they're very, very pretty. Then let's next. I have a lot of sparkly goodness right now. Let's next go to this from Essence. This is the new Chrome On Duochrome Liquid Eyeshadows with color changing effect. Depending on the angle of the light, the special chromatic pigments change color and give your eyes an extra dramatic look. I have actually seen these on Beauty Boozy Shop, but I think they only have three colors left. They have the blue, they have a green, and I think they had another color. I have two in my cart because I even though I don't use this type of product usually, I think I need to try these. Do I need to try these? I need to try these, don't I? Yeah, I kind of want that orange one, but I think the orange one was sold out, was it? Let me check.
A little longer than a few minutes later.
Oh, I think they have the orange. Oh, I have the orange one in my cart. So they have the blue purple, they have the orange green or something like that, and then they have the pinky green. So there was also a green to teal. They have that one is sold out, and then the dark green to purple is sold out as well. But that's on Boozy Shop, so I will leave Boozy Shop down below. I don't think that they ship these internationally though, so I will also check Cosmetic for Less and see if they have them. I don't know if they say they are an online exclusive. I don't know if these will be international. I don't think so, but I kind of want to try these. So I think I'm going to check where they have the most colors. Yeah, they are, if I'm not mistaken, €4.95 each. So yeah, let me know if you have tried them. Okay, let's next go to Colourpop because I have a bunch for Colourpop. Honestly, I have a lot from Colourpop. Let's start with this because this I really, really like. This is the Heading to the Lush Life collection. It drops for me tomorrow, for you yesterday. I really, really like this color story. And there is more in the collection. So you get an eyeshadow palette. You get some of the cheek do's, which I'm not interested in because I heard wonky stuff. You also get some... what are those? Can I see that? No. Let me go to Colourpop. Maybe I can see a little bit better what's in the... Oh, here. Yeah, you get a palette for 18. Luxe glosses for 8. Each 3 cheek do serum 7, each 3 cream gel liners for 7, and the full collection is 84. I'm actually wondering what the liners, what type of liners they are, because they have two types now. They have the twist up and they have the normal ones. If these are the normal ones, I'm very interested. If they are the twist up, I'm not interested because I don't like the twist ups from Colourpop. They dry out for me so quickly. I want ones that I need to sharpen myself. I feel that they stay better for longer. But the eyeshadow palette looks very, very pretty. I like the lip glosses as well. So I actually think I might pick this up. So let me know your thoughts. Have you picked it up or not? Let me know down below. Let's next though go to Colourpop. And this is their surprise drop. Which is, if I compare it to the one that I talked about just now, I'm like, I don't dislike it. But if I compare them to the one that I just talked about, I'm like, this is so boring. It's... compared to that, maybe it's more vibrant in person, but looking at the picture that I have now, it's more muted, which is not a bad thing. It's just, yeah, I don't know. And also a surprise drop, why? Oh, but they have free worldwide shipping all month long. Ooh, that is nice. That is very, very nice. Yes. Okay, let's next go to still Colourpop, but this is from Trend Mood. It's a sneak peek from their up-and-coming Cabana Club collection, and I think these are pictures from a magazine. This is going to go to Ulta coming soon in July. Yeah, it's people are saying that they have seen this before, and I kind of agree. I do, yeah. But then again, it's a teal. Give me a teal and a yellow, and a purple, and I'm sold. This looks, I think it looks very nice. In summary, but yeah, Ulta exclusive. I cannot shop at Ulta, and yeah, that's it. It's that teal that gets me, truly. The teal, the yellow, and then a purple and a peach. These are the colors that I have, but these are also the colors that really inspire me, especially this time of year. So yeah, have they done this before? Yeah, probably. They are releasing so much that they are bound to repeat themselves. You know, let me know your thoughts down below. I do kind of like the way that the eyeshadow palette is looking. I'm not gonna lie. I like it. Yes. Let's go next to a collab between Dose of Colors and Disney. They have done this, I think last year was Minnie and Mickey Mouse, I believe. This time it's Donald Duck and Daisy Duck. And you get an eyeshadow and bronzer palette for 39 lashes. There's a velvet mousse lipstick, Donald Duck, and then the Donald Duck velvet mousse lipstick, and then the Daisy Duck stay glossy lipstick or gloss. You get a lip liner, and the full collection is $103. It is available as I'm filming this today. Yeah, if you love Donald Duck or Daisy Duck, this could be something for you. I like the way that the lippies look though. I like the colors of those. I don't dislike the colors that are in the eyeshadow palette either. Yeah, it looks to be a few duochrome shades, or at least one duochrome shade. And what was that, a bronzer? I don't know who that bronzer is suited for though, looking at this picture, because this is a very, very, very pale bronzer. I think it's Oopsie Daisy. So I think that if you're then darker, you can use it as a eyeshadow. A very big ass eyeshadow. Yeah, I don't like that. Why didn't they just make it a six pan palette then? Because that bronzer shade, yeah, I don't know. That's suited for... Not a lot of people can use that as a bronzer. But that may be me. Let me know your thoughts. For the rest, I do kind of like it. I just don't get that bronzer in there. Yes, let's next go to something that I got sent by one of you. This is from Chaos Makeup, and this is their holochrome. It's a pre-order is now open, and it says here they have officially created a mixing medium gel that they are excited to chat about. Because we value your feedback, we're giving every holochrome pre-order a free jar to try out before we officially launch it. Use it to mix your pigments in or use it as a primer. Once it dries down, it holds it in place. So it is a gel-like texture. I think it's kind of interesting. So it's basically, it's a mixing medium. At least that's kind of how I feel, but then in a gel. A hybrid between a mixing medium and a glitter base. Huh. So that's why I wanted to mention it, because it sounds very, very interesting. And honestly, Chaos Makeup has such pretty, gorgeous, shiny, duochrome-y, beetle-like. Oh. Let me know if you tried this. Let me know down below. It's a very interesting product. Yes. Let's next go to Selfless by Hyram. I mentioned this when it was just being announced that he was coming out with a brand and then in basically collaboration with the Inky List. I needed to think, and it's also very, very yes. But we have the complete range here. I need to check though what the complete range is. Do I have it somewhere in a post? They have a salicylic acid and sea kelp pore cleaning and oil control serum. Yes, that is one thing. They have niacinamide and maracuja berry support moisturizer, a centella and green tea daily gel cleanser, retinol and rainbow algae repair serum, and a mandelic and rice bran gentle exfoliating serum. These products sound very, very interesting though, but I actually don't know if it is it online already though then. Am I very much... Oh, the 24th. That is for me tomorrow, for you yesterday. So for you, yes, it is online already. I am very interested in interested in trying this. Available online in stores at Sephora. So, I don't know. The Inky List, though, is sold in a bunch of different places here in Europe. So I actually don't know. I will check... Maybe it is in Beauty Bay. I will leave his own site down below in the description box. I will check if it's in Beauty Bay. If it is on Sephora, for me it will be Sephora France. But I will kind of see if I can find out where you can get it. It sounds very, very interesting. Honestly, I am very interested to try some of his stuff. Let me know your thoughts down below. Okay, let's next go to Revolution Pro, because they have launched something new and I actually saw it already. This is the Revolution Pro SPF Edit. It's a selection of makeup must-haves with added SPF to give your skin the care that it deserves. So you get a primer with SPF 50 Soft Focus Primer. There's also a Soft Focus Fixing Spray SPF 30, a Mattifying Translucent Pressed Setting Powder SPF 6, I have thoughts. I will get back to you. Hold on. But there's also a loose setting powder SPF 6 and then a conditioning lip balm SPF 15. Okay, let's... I thought we had passed the... Back in the day when I was growing up, if there was an SPF in a product at all, we could choose 2, 4, 6. And if you wanted to get really protected, you got 8. I thought we were kind of past that stage. Honestly, anything below SPF 30, it's mute. Yes, I use SPF 50. I want this to be as nice as possible for as long as possible. Why would I spend a lot of money on skincare, on makeup to make this look good and then not use sunscreen? A good sunscreen. That is me, though. That's personal. An SPF of 6, that's a gimmick. Why? Because to get the I will leave Lab Muffin Beauty Science channel down below. Go check her out. She is, she has a degree in chemistry and she is a skincare nerd. She has done research. Go watch her videos. Honestly. Yeah, basically the gist of it is you need about a quarter teaspoon for your face and then here to get the SPF listed on the label. Remember that. So an SPF of 6 that you dust over powder-wise, it's not going to do anything. I am for layering though. I am all for layering. So how do I use sunscreen products? I do my skincare. Then I apply a nice amount, the correct amount of SPF 50 on the face. And then makeup goes on top if I use makeup. I am not in full sunshine every day. So what do? I have that sunscreen, that base layer underneath. And then I apply products on top if I am going outside to walk my dog, to go to the grocery store, because if I'm sitting outside, I always have a hat on my head anyway, or I'm underneath a parasol. That's how I do it. So yes, I like to layer. So there are some products in here that I would really like to try. That powder though, I would like to try the powder, but because it's a powder and I'm interested to try the powder, and not because it has an SPF of 6. Yeah, so there's that. A lip balm, SPF 15. Yeah, but why only 15? Oh, what do we have then? Yes, that Soft Focus Fixing Spray, SPF 30. I have something similar like that. Something similar that is SPF 50. And that product really, really works. It's a weird experience to spray a sunscreen on your face without making you greasy. So I do like something like this to layer, to touch up, to just make sure that you have that even layer, but also a product that you can reapply on top of makeup very, very easily. You know, layering, I am all for layering. However, you cannot get more SPF than the maximum that you have on. And what do I mean by that? If the maximum SPF that you have on your face in your sunscreen is 50 and you put a primer with SPF 50 on top, you don't get SPF 100, you get SPF 50. You know? So that is how it works. So that Soft Focus primer I've actually been looking at, again, to layer. You know, I think that could be very, very interesting. Now, again, if I want to have the amount that I need to get that SPF of 50 with that primer, I have to put a shit ton of primer on my face. But if I can combine that with my SPF layer that I have underneath, so I do my sunscreen, then I do that primer on top, I then kind of fill in any gaps that I may have left over, you know. So that is how I see a range like this. Please don't think that you have enough if you just use the primer. You don't, honestly. It, you know, if you have a moisturizer with sunscreen in it, fine. I would still advise you to use a separate sunscreen on top of that. Layer, thin layers, you know. It's the money maker. I want to keep it as nice as possible. Just saying. But yeah, so yes, I think some things are very, very interesting. And other things I'm like, let me know your thoughts down below though. As I said, I do want to try stuff. But I will get it on a sale someday. I'm not going to pay full price, but if they have a nice sale and I'm ordering from Makeup Revolution anyway, yeah, I might just chuck something in, you know? Let's next go to this from Fatal Beauty. This is the Dia de los Muertos palette set. It's available already. The palette set retails for 36, so that's the two palettes, La Vida e Bella and Recuerdos. Am I saying that correctly? I don't know. I have no idea. You can use code RADAR10 for 10% off, and that's affiliated. It's not from me, but it's from Makeup Release Radar that the post is from. I like this. I love that aesthetic. I love Dia de los Muertos. I am still bummed that I did not get the melt palettes, but I think I'm not alone in that. This looks gorgeous, and I like the two sides as well. I like it a lot. Yeah, let me know your thoughts down below. I have mentioned this a few times, but I will mention it again because I know that I have new people watching this video. From July the 1st, the import tax rules for us here in the Netherlands and Belgium are going to change. It's basically for a lot of Europe it's going to change. The threshold that we used to have of 22 euros, it's gone. So that means that everything we order outside of the EU, that includes the UK, because they are no longer in the EU either, we have to pay import tax for. And import tax is 21% taxes on the amount that you spend, not including shipping. And then you have to also pay a handling fee from the postal service. Now, the postal service handling fee used to be around 11 or 12 euro. I know that PostNL, which is basically our main mail courier, is bringing it down to between 4 or 5 euros. So that is a lot cheaper. But still, that makes everything a lot more expensive. So I am really checking, what do I want? Do I find it interesting enough? Do I want to try it enough to pay the 21% extra plus shipping, plus the 4 or 5 euro handling fee? Well, I really do like this, and I would love to try it. I don't know the brand enough to invest that in right now. Does that make any sense at all? So let me know if you have tried Fatal Beauty. Let me know if this is a formula that is bombdiggity.com that I need to try. Because I really like the look of this. It's just that, yeah, I am going to be a little bit more... Honestly, Europe, I'm going to be a little bit more towards what we can get here in Europe, not gonna lie. So yeah, and I know that what I said about Colourpop, but I know Colourpop's formula. And if I can basically not pay the shipping and then keep my order a little bit lower, not pay the shipping, and then if I then combine it with the handling fee and all that, it's kind of, it's a tad more expensive, but not a lot. So yeah, let me know down below, because also, indie brands have usually a high shipping rate because they are small. It is the way it is. It's the same with you guys from the USA ordering anything from Europe. The shipping is higher. It's just the way that it is. But that was, yeah, extra information. Yes, it's, did you grab your drink and your snack? Because you probably need it. Let's next, oh, by the way, before I forget, for you Dutchies out there, Root Cosmetics is now sold at Ici Paris. They even have it in store where I live, and I was like, what's happening here? We never get those exciting things. So if you are eyeing Root Cosmetics, which is basically drugstore pricing, but very nice products they have, Ici Paris, they have it. Yes. It's just bling bling, sometimes that happens, ADHD, ole ole. Yes, let's go to Artitude Cosmetics, because they are doing this. Highly pigmented, smudge-proof, waterproof eyeliner that lasts all day, which doubles up as lash adhesive. No more lash glue, no more mess, easy application. They retail for 12 British pounds each, and that is approximately around between 16 and 17 bucks. The only reason that I would not buy this is basically because my eyes are older, they are deep set, but they're hanging. You can see that, right? I am, as I said in the beginning, 45. That means that if I do a wing, I have to do a whale tail. That means that I have to draw, I have to look forward with my eyes relaxed. I have to draw a wing as if there were no folds. And then basically when I look down, I kind of fill in the gaps a little bit. The trouble with a product like this is if I do that, shit sticks together. And I don't have colored liners to, yeah, I do, but they are gel pot liners, and I don't use those a lot. So while I really like the concept of this, for me, you know, let me know. Have you tried these? I will link the site down below. Let me know what your thoughts are. Yes. Oh, yes. Something I'm interested in as well. This is from Fenty, and this is the Gloss Bomb Heat. It works. It's a plumping gloss. It works by using a mix of pepper and ginger root. Oh, I love that combination in food as well. Never mind. That instantly plumps for juicy lips. Come and etch it in hot. Cherry, this shade has a hint of tint that is flattering on everyone. If I am going to order anything from Sephora France and this is there, I'm going to try it. I love plumping glosses. With a passion. My favorite is the one from Nabla. Is that, yeah, the Viper? That's my favorite. I really want to try this one. It launched for me tomorrow, for you yesterday. Yeah. And there is other things that I am eyeing from Sephora. So this is going to go in my wish list. Yes. Let's go next to Nabla. Because Nabla is releasing two new cutie palettes. They will retail for $24. You get Midnight and Analog. There will also be three Cupid's Arrow Liner Pencils in Beige Biscuit, Midnight Blue, Medium Cherry Brown. It's available now. But it will also come to the Trend Mood box next week. That was 5 days ago. I think that launches very, very soon as well. I've never tried their cutie palettes. Is there only one matte in the blue? Really? Yeah, that's not... No. Oh, I'm apparently hungry. I kind of like the warm neutral one. I know, who am I? But yeah, I have that as well. And I still really, really want to try the Nabla eyeshadow formula. But this, looking at the neutral one, the warm neutrals, I have. You know, although these are colors. It's not brown. It's yellow, orange and red. So, you know, and the blue, there's only one matte. If there had been another matte, I may have been tempted. But as it stands right now, yeah, I am going to let this one go. I thought that I would say to you, I really want to get these, but yeah, I actually don't. While I love how they are looking color story wise, the neutral, warm neutral one I have, the blue, it's only one matte, and I have. So I'm going to skip over. Yes, let's next go to, yeah, this looks very pretty. Oh, this looks very, very cute. See, this is from Laura Lee. And this is Laura Lee Los Angeles. It's the Candy Skies collection. It is finally revealed. It is online already if it is not sold out. I don't know if it's sold out. The palette retails for $45. You also get a gloss for $16. Oh, two glosses. $16 each. Then the Candy Skies full collection bundle is $59. That's a nice bundle. And then there's also a lip gloss bundle for $24. And that saves you $8. That's a those are nice bundles. I like the look of this palette. I like the color story a lot, actually. I was not planning on picking it up, but I do like it. Can I get Laura Lee here? No, I don't think so. I think I need to, yeah, from that's then from the USA, so no. But I would love to try this, actually. This looks very, very fun, summery. It has some pastels, but they look still vibrant. Different shimmers in there. Yeah, it looks very, very pretty. Very pretty. Let me know your thoughts. Have you picked it up? I would love to try it, but I'm not going to buy it. Oh, that rhymes. Yes. Let's go next to this from Natasha Denona. This is their sneak peek mini Xenon palette. It will be available in fall. Isn't she a little bit late to the party with this one? Honestly, if you want this color story in a great formula, the Blow and Smoke from Colourpop. I don't know if it has been discontinued, but if you can get your hands on that one, it's so, so good. What else do I have? I have one from Makeup Obsession that is even more exciting than this because it has a very, very pretty different shimmer finishes in there, and that's one of their small 9-pen ones from Makeup Obsession, the Smoke-In. But honestly, the quality on this is amazing. And this shade Sizzle in the middle, I don't know if you can see it. I cannot swatch it because I cannot dig my finger in. I don't buy this. Don't buy this for $25. No, she has other palettes that are way more fun. You can get this drugstore pricing and great quality. Truly, truly, don't buy this. No. No, save your money for something else. Let's go next to a new brand, which is... Oh no, don't do this. Which is the brand Woma by Sharon. This is an inclusive sister brand to the Woma beauty brand. It's a conscious, eco-friendly, vegan and cruelty-free brand that centers around care. So skincare, self-care, soul care, care for our planet, care for our furry friends, and care for all of us. Makeup and skincare with affordable prices made with naturally derived ingredients and sustainable packaging. This needs to come to Beauty Bay. Because I want to try this. I asked. They are right now exclusively online at Walmart Beauty and Walmart. It is available already. It's not fair that it's not coming to Beauty Bay. I would really love, I really want to try this. Yeah, so what do they have? A cleansing oil for $15. They have 2-in-1 water activated cleansing wipes, but these are dry makeup remover biodegradable wipes. They are wipes, they are made from cotton, I believe. Yeah, no alcohol, no hefty stuff in it, and it is just add water, that's it. So if you still want to use a makeup wipe type product, this may be something for you. I don't know how well they clean though, but maybe it's something for you. They retail for $6. Then you get some serums, what's that? C10. So that's vitamin C, 10% I think for $18. Then 20% for $24. The foundation is $15. Then you get lip tint, oil, and gloss for $7. It's a non-sticky oil and water formula that keeps your lips hydrated. If you're here in Europe and you want a very nice cheap lip oil, get the ones from Catrice, the 5-in-1s. They are truly, truly amazing. And they also have a mascara for $8. I'm going to say it again. Please get this to Beauty Bay ASAP. Please. Yes. Let me know if you've tried anything. Let's next go to e.l.f. because they have putty bronzers. I want to try one of these. I don't know why one looks purple and the other one looks gray on my screen, but yeah, can I get this in store? I don't know, because I kind of need to see it in the color, you know. They are available now for $8 each. If you are an olive, a light olive or medium olive, let me know if you've tried this and let me know the shade, because I am very interested. Yes, yeah, I would love to try this. I would love to try this and be able to say to you guys, this is a dupe for the KKW stick. But I do want to try this though. If I see them in store and I see a shade that I think could work, I will try it. And otherwise, if you have, please let me know. Then I have something from iHeart Revolution, because I was quite a while ago that they kind of sneak peeked watermelon stuff. Now they already have a watermelon eyeshadow palette, but they are expanding on their watermelon range. You get lip glosses in 4 shades, a waterproof mascara, a serum primer, watermelon highlighter, which is 3D, a tasty highlighter. Oh yeah, that was pretty cute. Lip scrub and a lip mask, and it is available now. It looks, I love watermelon. I actually bought a watermelon today in the grocery store. I think it is 12 kilos. I can exercise with that thing. It's, yeah, truly. I wasn't planning on trying anything. I could see myself trying the lip mask or maybe even a lip gloss. Yeah, but for the rest, maybe the serum primer as well. I don't know. I have seen it. It is online already and I will link it. So let's next go to Makeup Obsession. They have 4 new mini blush palettes and 2 mini highlight palettes to add to your collection. And I'm actually pretty interested in these. Now, I am not really a face palette type of person, honestly. But I love Makeup Obsession. I love these. I kind of want to try this. So, yeah, they have 4 blush palettes, 2 highlight palettes. The highlighter palettes are not really something that I go for, but that blush palette, there are, yeah, the peach and then the strawberry dreams are kind of what I am very much eyeing. Yes. So let's go to this, which I actually just saw now. This is from Morphe. They are coming out with a new hydrating tinted moisturizer. Will they then have maybe an olive one? That would be nice, because they usually do not. It has a SPF 30. Meh. It comes in 15 tints and it will be $18. They will be available July the 8th on their website and in stores. Huh. I actually think that's kind of interesting. Okay, so I'm going to end on this. I just saw a new thing from KKW. This is a lip lacquer pot collection. So yeah, it's a lip lacquer in a pot with a brush, but you have to buy the brush separately. So basically the colors are pretty. Yeah, I like the colors. The colors are pretty. It says here,
new decadent coconut and vanilla flavored lip lacquer. Smooth creamy texture glides effortlessly on the lips with a kiss of color.
So basically it's a lip balm.
Marula and jojoba oil softens and...
Blah, blah. Four shades. Yeah, four shades. They retail for 18 bucks. And there's also a lip brush. It's synthetic hair, so that's nice. That's also 18. If you want to get a pot and a brush, it will retail for 32. And the full collection is 80. They will be available June the 25th, noon PST. So basically, this is a tinted lip balm in a pot. Really? Now? In Corona time? When everyone is very, very conscious of where they are with their fingers, you're going to come out with something like this. Okay then. I like the way that the brush is looking. Let's just... The brush is pretty. It's a pretty brush. 18 bucks, really? Anyway, that was it for this week. I am still here to give a special shout out to my members because it is that time of the week again. You will see my members scrolling across the screen. If you want to become a member, there is a link to join in the description box. And what do you get for being a member? You get a raven emoji behind your name in the comment section. You get special raven emojis to use as well in the comment section and in live chat. And you get a members only videos, which will be at the first of the month. Now, actually, for this month, I was actually thinking about doing a live chat, but I have to kind of see the time, because yeah, I'm in the Netherlands and most of you guys are in the USA, so maybe we can kind of come to an agreement, or maybe I'm just going to schedule it on a Saturday or Sunday. Maybe that is then better, so not a lot of people have to go to work or something like that. If you are a member, please let me know down below in the comment section. I think it's going to be a Saturday or a Sunday. Yes, let me know your thoughts. And yeah, if you are a member, there is a members only playlist as well, and you can watch everything that is in the playlist. I only have one tier. And that is it for today. Thank you so much for watching. If you liked the video, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section below. I am going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening. May your foundation always match your neck. And I will see you Monday for another video. Bye guys.